It is 6:34, and right now concerns over toxic air have prompted Georgia's governor and other state leaders to file a restraining order against a sterilization facility in Newton County.
They want Becton Dickinson temporarily shut down. Our Rebecca Schramm's live in Covington. And Rebecca, any sign the company is going to take a cue from the governor and temporarily close the doors on its own?
Not at all, Karen and Megan. Good morning to you. In fact, you can see for yourself, looks like normal activity here at the BD plant, which uses ethylene oxide to sterilize medical equipment. People showing up for work, but the question is, will operations soon come to a standstill by order of a judge? Late yesterday, Georgia Attorney General Chris Carr, on behalf of Governor Brian Kemp and state environmental regulators, filed that temporary restraining order in Newton County Superior Court. The complaint specifically cites a recent leak of the potentially cancer-causing gas, ethylene oxide, saying the company was not forthcoming about how long the leak went on and how much gas was leaked. BD argues that point. Now, there's no date yet for the hearing, but in the meantime, the state is asking the judge to suspend BD's operations until the company can prove it has upgraded its pollution controls. I was talking with a woman last week who has lived close to the plant her whole life. I was asking about the recent air quality testing that showed a high level of the gas in her neighborhood. She said she can't help but wonder if exposure has affected her family.
I have a sister that has non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. I had a sister that died 3 years ago from here that died with pancreatic cancer.
And it makes you wonder.
It makes me wonder what they're killing us with. Do I think they'll voluntarily do it? No. They'll have to be forced to close down.
Now, company officials released a statement last night accusing the governor and other state leaders of ignoring science. They also point out that if this company shuts down, Georgia patients will be at risk because they won't have access to sterilized medical equipment. So the company is vowing to fight this. We'll let you know how the judge decides. Live in Covington this morning, Rebecca Schramm, CBS 46 News.